So one of my friends on Facebook told me to watch this series called Akatsuki no Yona, and according to her it's an underrated gem. So I give it a shot and my god, he was not wrong. This series is so freaking good, having a really great, well developed, badass female protagonist along with her companions. So let's talk about Akatsuki no Yona right now. The manga of Akatsuki no Yona is written by Mizuho Kusanagi and it's getting an anime adaptation by Studio Parrot. Yes, you heard it right. Fucking Parrot. The same goddamn studio that is responsible for Tokyo Ghoul anime. I can't believe Studio Parrot messed up Tokyo Ghoul and gave us this. The animation and art style is really freaking good, and most importantly, the adaptation was on point. And I still don't understand how they end up fucking Tokyo Ghoul. Akatsuki no Yona is such a wonderful series for multiple reasons. First of all, the plot. It's nothing new, the betrayal and royalty, but the way it was portrayed with mythical elements in it was fascinating. You can feel the tension in the atmosphere. People think that the series is slow paced and that's a bad thing, but I have to disagree. The slow paced start is necessary to build things up, otherwise it felt rushed and incomplete. It took numerous episodes to build Yona's character from being a spoiled brat to a badass character, and I feel like it can't be done in just 3 or 4 episodes. And not only Yona, but the characters along on her journey, the four dragons, also got character development, and that's something I'm glad happens. One thing I really like is how distinguished yet how close these dragons are. All four of them have completely different stories, yet they are connected to each other. And out of which Zeno's story is what hit me the most. Oh my god. That was really heartbreaking. Besides characters, the comedy is fucking gold. It didn't feel flat or forced, and the change in art style is what make it more entertaining. Though it reminded me of Your Lie in April and how it changes the art style for comedy. Romance in this series is just fine, and believe me, it's not reverse harem because many people confuse it with being reverse harem. There is just one-sided love, which is between Yona and Hawk. The action is really good as well, and it's well animated and well choreographic. So my overall thought, it's an extremely good series. I'm still waiting for season 2, but it's likely there will be none because of how underrated this series is. But there is still some ray of hope, and I'm planning on reading the manga as well since things are heating up. But that's it when it comes to this video. If you enjoy this, please like and subscribe for more, and I will talk to you guys later. Until then, peace.